Let's start from the beginning. Ancient Rome. According to the founding myth of Rome, the city was founded in 753 before Christ by twin brothers Romulus and Remus, who were grandsons of the Latin king Numitor of Alba Longa. Numitor king was deposed from his throne by his brother Amulius, who feared Romulus and Remus would take back the throne, so he ordered them to be drowned. A she-wolf shaved and raised them, and when they were old enough, they returned the throne of Alba Longa to Numitor. The twins then founded their own city. Roman society was divided into slaves at the bottom, those belonging to its owner and had no rights. Above slaves were plebeians, who were most of the population. At the top of society were the patricians. They had all the rights, and whose ancestors could be tracked back to the founding of the city. The Romans enjoyed their free time in public performances that were offered in the circus, theater or amphitheater, which were buildings for the fun of citizens. The circus was the largest installation. It was destined to the races. Roman monarchy was the first political form of government of the city-state of Rome. From the legendary moment of its foundation in 753 before Christ until the end of the monarchy in 510, when the last king was exiled, establishing the Roman Republic. The Republic was a period of ancient Rome in which the city and its territories had a system of government by youth elected by assemblies of citizens in the context of a state right. The Empire was the third stage of development of ancient Rome, and the main political institution of the state was the imperial monarchy, formed by the emperor, his ministers, advisors, and provincial governors. What about the architecture of the ancient Rome? The Pantheon is a building in Rome, commissioned by Marcus Agrippa. The building is a circular with a portico of large granite Corinthian columns under a pediment. A rectangular vestibule links the porch to the rotunda, which is under a coffered concrete dome with a central opening to the sky. Almost 2,000 years after it was built, the Pantheon's dome is still the world's largest unreinforced concrete dome. The Colosseum is an elliptical amphitheater in the center of the city of Rome, built of concrete and stone. It is the largest amphitheater ever built and is considered one of the greatest works of architecture and engineering. The Castel Sant'Angelo is a towering cylindrical building in Rome. It was initially commissioned by the Roman Emperor Hadrian as a mausoleum for himself and his family. The building was later used by the popes as a fortress and castle, and is now a museum. The Roman Forum is a rectangular forum surrounded by the ruins of several important ancient government buildings at the center of the city of Rome. It was for centuries the center of Roman public life, the site of triumphal procession and election. It has been called the most celebrated meeting place in the world and in all history, attracting 4.5 million sightseers yearly. Many of the oldest and most important structures of the ancient city were located on or near the Forum.
The history of the Renaissance architecture is divided into two periods. Quattrocento, also called the Early Renaissance, is the moment when the leading figures of Brunelleschi and Alberti stand out. In this period, the concept of architectural order were explored and rules were formulated. The study of classical antiquity led, in particular, to the adoption of classical detail and ornamentation. The prime example of this is the Basilica di San Lorenzo in Florence. Then we have the Cinquecento, which is divided into two phases. During the High Renaissance, concepts derived from classical antiquity were developed and used with great surety. The most representative architect is Bramante, who expanded the applicability of classical architecture to contemporary buildings. His San Pietro in Montorio was directly inspired by circular Roman temples. He was, however, hardly a slave to the classical forms, and it was his style that was to dominate Italian architecture in the 16th century. During the Mannerist period, architects experimented with using architectural forms to emphasize solid and spatial relationships. The best known architect associated with the Mannerist style was Michelangelo, who is credited with inventing the giant order, a large pilaster that stretches from the bottom to the top of a facade. He used this in his design for the Campidoglio in Rome. And then I'm going to say some monuments of the Renaissance. We have the Sixtine Chapel that is located in the Vatican City. It was originally known as the Cappella Magna. The chapel takes its name from Pope Sixtus, who restored it between 1477 and 1480. Since that time, the chapel has served as a place for both religious and functionary papal activity. Today is the site of the papal conclave, the process by which a new pope is selected. The fame of the Sixtine Chapel lies mainly in the frescoes that decorate the interior, and most particularly the Sixtine Chapel ceiling and the Last Judgment by Michelangelo. Then we have San Agostino, which is one of the first Roman churches built during the Renaissance. Now we have the St. Peter's Basilica. St. Peter's is the most renowned work of Renaissance architecture and remains one of the two largest churches in the world. Designed principally by Bramante, Michelangelo, Carlo Maderno and Bernini. And finally we have Santa Maria del Popolo, which was rebuilt by Ponchielli and Andrea Bregno in 1472 to 1477 on the orders of Pope Sixtus, and was given to the Congregation of Lombard Friars in Rome.
Piazza di Spagna. The Piazza di Spagna at the bottom of the Spanish Steps is one of the most famous squares in Rome. It owes its name to the Palazzo di Spagna, seat of the Embassy of Spain among the Holy See. In the middle of the square is the famous Fontana della Baraccia, dating to the beginning of the Baroque period, sculpted by Pietro Bernini and his sons. The Piazza Navona is a big square in Rome, which is built on the site of the Stadium of Domitian in the 1st century AD, and follows the form of the open space of the stadium. It was defined as a public space in the last years of the 15th century, when the city market was transferred to it from the Campidoglio. The Piazza Navona was transformed into a highly significant example of Baroque Roman architecture and art. Piazza Navona has two additional fountains. At the southern end is the Fontana del Moro, with a basin and four treaters sculpted by Giacomo della Porta, 1575, to which Bernini added a statue of a Moor wrestling with a dolphin. And at center stands the famous Fontana dei Quattro Fiumi, 1651, by Gian Lorenzo Bernini, topped by the obelisk of Domitian, brought here in pieces from the Circus of Maxentius. Gian Lorenzo Bernini, an Italian artist and prominent architect who worked principally in Rome. He was the leading sculptor of his age, creating the Baroque style of sculpture. In addition, he painted, wrote plays, and designed metalworks and stage sets. Bernini had the ability to depict dramatic narratives with characters showing intense psychological states, but also to organize large-scale sculptural works which convey a magnificent greatness. Bernini's architectural works include sacred and secular buildings, and sometimes their urban settings and interiors. Francesco Borromini, with his contemporaries Gian Lorenzo Bernini and Pietro da Cortona, was a leading figure in the emergence of Roman Baroque architecture. A keen student of the architecture of Michelangelo and the ruins of antiquity, Borromini developed an inventive and distinctive geometrical rationale in his plans and symbolic meanings in his buildings. In 1634, Borromini designed his first major independent commission to design the church, cloister and monastic building of San Carlo alle Quattro Fontane, situated on the Quirinal Hill in Rome. The complex was designed for the Spanish Trinitaria, a religious order. From 1640 to 1650, he worked on the design of the church of Saint Ivo alla Sapienza. Borromini was one of the several architects involved in the building of the Church of Saint Agnes in Agonese, Rome. The Fontana di Trevi is a fountain in the Trevi district, designed by an Italian architect called Nicola Salvi and completed by Pietro Bracci. Standing 26.3 meters high and 49.15 meters wide, it is the largest Baroque fountain in the city, and one of the most famous fountains in the world. This fountain marks the end of the modern Aqua Virgin, one of the aqueducts that supplied water to the ancient Rome in 19 before Christ.
Contemporary actual Rome. Rome, the Città Eterna, is an Italian town of the region of Lazio. With 2,872,082 inhabitants, it is the fourth most populated city in Europe. Rome is the capital of Italy. Historical capital for its high concentration of historical and architecture worldwide, and capital of two states. Besides being the capital of Italy, it is also of the Papal States and itself of the Catholic Church. Shield. The city motto is SPQR, Senatus Populus Que Latin Romanus, the Senate and People of Rome, indicating that in ancient times there were two classes that constitute the Roman society, composition and foreign ethnic minorities. Rome is the city with the highest number of foreigners from 182 different countries, almost 10% of the total resident population. Festivities and traditions. A current Roman folk customs are dives into the Tiber during New Year celebrations. Daring cliff divers plunge into its cool waters. The birth of Rome, April 21, is the date on which, according to the tradition, Romulus had founded the city. April 21 is celebrated with performances in costumes, musical events and recreational events. On May 1, the party workers' unions organize a free concert together. The Feast of the Republic, on June 2, the traditional military parade takes place. The Noantri Festival takes place in Trastevere. The first Sunday is celebrated after July 16th of the occasion of the call to the Virgin Carmelo. Latest history. When the Second Empire fell in 1870, there were no longer obstacles to proceed to incorporate the state of the church. Pius IX was forced to retire. There were granted only the Vatican, the Lateran, and Castel Gandolfo Papadilla. Rome, therefore, was incorporated into the Kingdom of Italy, which becomes capital. The First World War concluded in Rome and in Italy with the mutilated victory. The city is in a climate of lawlessness and political uncertainty, which, in 1922, favored the rise of Benito Mussolini.
October 28th through the Cop known as the March on Rome. In 1940, Italy entered in the Second World War. Rome, a scene of attacks and massacres, after being declared by the Germans as an open city, was liberated by the Allies in 1944. After the war, Rome, after the referendum of 1946, becomes again the capital of the Italian Republic. In the 50s and 60s, the city developed urban and demographically, and since the Jubileum 1950, it became one of the most desired destinations. Contemporary monuments are used to be dedicated to arts, museums. The most important ones are Auditorium Parco della Musica, three concert halls, and Outdoor Plaza by Renzo Piano. The Macro is the Museum of Contemporary Art in Rome by Odile Deck, which combines the old building with the modern and colorful shapes.